Gowri. I'm so happy to be here. Thank you to the American Humanist Association. Thank you for the organizers of the Secular Social Justice Conference. Thank you to Sincere, who when he first emailed me, I wrote him back and said, oh my God, I know you from online writing and stuff. So I'm very happy to be here. I'm gonna share a few poems with you today, and I will share background on most of them, except for this first one, which I like to think speaks for itself. It's an older poem of mine, and I think a lot of people who do any kind of performance-oriented poetry, any kind of sort of, we're meant to share it in community-style poetry, a lot of us have these pieces that are sort of our answer to the question, who cares? Who cares about poetry? Who cares about art? There are always more important things going on. So this is one of my answers to the question. It's called How to Be a Model Minority. They say be still, be small, stay seated, stop squirming. This may be your life, but they'll say what it's made of. They say a little sweetener on a spoon will make it smooth when the meds go down. They say they have the recipe to make you function, to pop, pop, snap till you crackle. They say poetry is dead, or should be, because words are useless. Just whining and rhyming, hypnotizing, just fine, proselytizing. They don't see the uprising, but why would they? They say dissent is a sign that something bad is up your sleeve. When bent, kneed, cuffed, and pleading, you dare to ask why. They say you belong with a he, and you with a she, and who makes the rules we, because they say you don't know what's good for you. They say you're the different, the misstep, the wrong color of the rainbow. They say they don't know where you belong, but it's not here. Because this is their story, and you weren't there, not even a footnote. Defeated, deleted, and then not even indexed. They say your name never came up. To be a model minority, just keep your mouth shut or open it. And together, we will lift ourselves up. Thank you. So this next poem of mine is what's known as a found poem. People know about found poetry at all. It's one of my favorite forms of poetry because it's sort of an encouragement and a challenge to go about our days looking for where poetry already exists, or looking for where these moments of inspiration are literally just jumping at you from a movie or a TV show or a newspaper article or a pamphlet or a mission statement. It can be found anywhere. And there are different ways to write found poetry. Sometimes a found poem is solely comprised of words and text that the writer has found written elsewhere already. And sometimes the writer takes further kind of influence and steps to make it more their own. So this is a found poem that it was written for me. The universe wrote it in front of my face. Last year on Earth Day, I was at a science museum in Connecticut, and I was reading a museum label excerpt, which I happen to think museum curators write some really amazing poetry, as it is. But I was reading this excerpt of a museum label, and I was sort of laughing to myself, saying, I feel like I could just substitute this one phrase for this one phrase, and the whole thing would still make sense. So all I've done is to take an excerpt from a museum label and changed every instance of sedimentary minerals and rocks to read people of the global majority. And if you don't know, people of the global majority is a phrase that can be used synonymously with phrases like people of color or my favorite, which is used a lot in the US, which is minority. This poem is called Sedimentary Rocks. People of the global majority are extremely varied, differing widely in texture, color, and composition. In total, these people cover about 3/4 of the Earth's surface. Nearly all are made of materials that have been moved from a place of origin to a new place of deposition. The distance moved may be a few feet or thousands of miles. Most people of the global majority form in layers or strata. Many contain fossils. So many museums in this town, I encourage you to go out and have some fun if you have any free time while you're here. This next poem is a poem that I wrote years ago as part of a project called Hope Spoken Broken. And before I share about the poem and share the poem itself, I just want to take a moment to pay respects to Yasser Murtaja and the other Palestinian activists and members of the press, clearly marked as members of the press, who were murdered by Israeli Defense Forces. This poem that I'm about to share with you, I wrote as part of the Hope Spoken Broken Project, which linked young people from Jabalia refugee camp in Palestine with poets and spoken word artists in Washington, D.C. And when I say young people in Jabalia, I'm talking about people who at the time that we did this project were 21, 22, 23 years old and had been born and raised in Jabalia refugee camp. The poem that I'm sharing with you, just a couple of references I would provide some background on beforehand, are that it references some different traditional dance styles, such as Dabke in Palestine, and Kummi in Sri Lanka, and it also references the part of Sri Lanka that my family is from, which is part of the historical Tamil people's homeland. Tamil people have been the victims of decades-long genocide at the hands of the Sri Lankan government. And the other reference is one you may recognize, or some of you may recognize, which some of the lines of the poem borrow from the very famous US-American protest song, We Shall Overcome. The poem is called Footprints. We stomp footprints into dirt, merge our heels with our roots. Like trees planted by the water, we shall not be moved, except by the force of our own feet, delight in our own dances. We ask for what is ours to be returned to us. We remember every heart that has died broken. We celebrate that we are here, haunted but healing. We shall not be moved except by the force of our own feet, delight in our own dances. Dabke in Jabalia, Kummi in Jaffna, Gogo in DC. Like palpitations underground shift tectonic plates, some have tried with equal force to steal us from our place. This skin is the sun-stained color of soil my grandmother's grandmother walked on, survived on, thrived on. Now soldiers' families settle the land my people were built on. If we were trees planted by the water, would you hear the lumberjack shout timber to warn you? Get out of the way. The ground beneath your feet is about to shake. Semi-local to the DMV area. Lots of people. Now you will hear promos, folks. Just a couple, though, that I think are pretty relevant. One is there is a nonprofit arts organization 5-minute walk from here called BloomBars. BloomBars is an all-ages arts organization. We do all kinds of stuff there. This coming Monday, we'll be having an open mic on race and identity that I'll be co-hosting, and it'll be based on a workshop that a wonderful writer in the city named Shaheen Qureshi just facilitated for several weeks. So we're gonna hear from a lot of the students, and there will be other spots open for other folks, and I encourage you to come to BloomBars anytime. You can check us out, bloombars.com. We're all ages all the time. There's never alcohol on the premises, never adult content, so that we are accessible to all ages. And everything is by donation. Artists are compensated for what they do, but no one is ever turned away at the door if they can't make a donation, because we very much want art to be a mode of building community and not shutting people out. So please come check it out, check out any of our events there or online. The other thing I wanted to let you know about was Split This Rock, which was mentioned earlier. That's a social justice poetry person. Split This Rock is an over 10-year-old organization now here in DC. It started off as DC Poets Against the War. And they do a poetry conference and a whole bunch of poetry events all year long, but the poetry conference happens every 2 years. It's happening at the end of April this year. The best thing about the poetry conference is it brings internationally renowned poets who specifically focus their work on social justice issues and also do social justice work every time that poets are featured. And you don't have to register for the conference to benefit from it, because if you don't mind not going to things like panels and workshops during the day, every single night there's a 2+ hour long free poetry reading down at National Geographic featuring just amazing poets from all over the world. So I encourage you to check them out. Their website is splitthisrock.org. They get their name from a Langston Hughes poem called Big Buddy, and the relevant lines from that poem, which I think might also move folks who are at a social justice conference, the lines say, "Don't you hear this hammer ring? I'm going to split this rock and split it wide. When I split this rock, stand by my side." So check them out, splitthisrock.org. This last poem I'm going to share was initially published by Split This Rock. They have a great poetry database called The Quarry. You can search it by theme, by topic, by movement, by background of author. It's a really great thing to check out before organizing meetings or any kind of healing circle or any kind of email where you're trying to also keep people motivated and moved. This poem is called Hold. We're taught to hold hands when we cross the street, or walk with our mothers in parking lots, or navigate crowds with a friend and don't want to end up alone. Hold hands with whomever is closest when the power goes out, when the sirens scream near, when the moving of men marches silences into the corner. Hold hands when they come calling, when they threaten, "This is necessary to teach you a lesson," or "This is necessary to protect you." Hold hands when we stand still, when we walk, when we run, when they tell us to surrender, when they tell us to do anything. Hold hands when we fall from the sky, with or without parachute, when we leap from tall buildings, with or without the ability to fly. Hold hands with the ones who don't look like us, talk like us, believe like us. Hands like fragile boxes or bombs, things that could break or explode. Each finger a troop in the human army, each gesture a shield. Thank you.